Hello everyone, Remedy Guy here. So the official Windows 11 has finally been released last October 5th, and for the past 6 days that I've been using it, I must say that the overall UI looks refreshing and it feels good using it. Unfortunately though, for some of us that still owns an old computer, there will be a requirement that your computer needs to have for you to install Windows 11 like TPM chip and a newer processor. But lucky for us, there are ways to bypass these requirements so we can still be able to experience Windows 11, and I'll be showing you how right now. So what I'm going to be using for this tutorial is a very old machine with an Intel i7-3770D processor. It also doesn't have any TPM chip on its motherboard, and this is where we're going to install Windows 11 as its operating system. But before we start, I just want to warn you that this is a do-it-at-your-own-risk thing, since Microsoft did make it clear in their article here that it is not recommended to install Windows 11 to compatible devices because it might cause compatibility issues, your device might malfunction, and also you're not guaranteed to receive future updates. As much as I'd love to do these kinds of tutorials, I don't want to be held liable to what might happen to your computer, so do it at your own risk. Now that's out of the way, let's get started. So if you're not familiar with your machine and you want to check what requirements your machine meets, I'd suggest you download Windows PC Health Check app. You can get this app by going to Google and type in Windows 11 Health Checkup in search box. Click the first link, then scroll all the way down until you see the Download PC Health Checkup. As you can see here, this machine pretty much checks all the boxes when it comes to not meeting the requirements. It doesn't have TPM, the processor is incompatible, and it even says here 14 years old. I don't know what it means, but I'm assuming it's the age of the machine. And also, by typing tpm.msc in start menu, you can also check if you have TPM chip in your motherboard if you don't feel like downloading the PC Health Check app. Next, what we're going to need to do is to download Windows 11 installer. Go to Google again and type in Windows 11 ISO. Again, click the first link that's going to show up. So there are three download links here. The first one is the easiest way you can upgrade to Windows 11, but it only works best if your machine meets all the requirements. The second one if you want to download Media Creation Tool or if you want to make a bootable USB. But in this procedure, what we need is the third one. Select Windows 11, then press Download. Select English as the language, press Confirm. Lastly, select 64-bit download. The download may take a while depending on the speed of your internet because it's a 5GB ISO file. After downloading, if this is the first time you'll extract an ISO, you can use WinRAR, but there are other options like 7-Zip and they're all free to download. If you're curious and you want to see what happens if you run the Windows 11 setup from the get-go, this is what you'll see. You will get a message that will specify the requirements your computer didn't meet and your installation won't proceed. Normally, we can bypass the requirement just by adding a key to Registry Editor provided by Microsoft here in their article, but since this machine doesn't have any TPM at all, this won't work if you don't have at least TPM 1.2. For that reason, we will use a different one. So the script we're going to be using is inside this GitHub created by Aveo. The link is in the description below. Click the green button, then download zip. After that, extract the file. Click the folder, then go inside the folder named MCT. And the script we need is the third one that says skip TPM check on dynamic setup version 2. Then double click it. There will be a PowerShell window that's going to show up that says that the skip TPM check on dynamic update is now installed. Then it will close automatically after 5 seconds. And we can now go back to Windows 11 setup to check if we can go past the requirement checker window this time. If you see this window, this is the indication that we got past the requirement checker and the installation will go smoothly at this point. Click accept and wait for the installation to do its thing. And the last warning will show up that will remind you that Microsoft and the manufacturer will not be held liable in any way if you damage your computer caused by installing Windows 11 in it. So if you really made up your mind, you can now click Accept. Then install. At this point, I'm going to go speed up the video so you can see what you'll expect on your screen during the entirety of your installation. This might take a while, and for reference, the whole installation process when I did this took about 2 hours. But of course, it also depends on your machine and your internet connection. The older the machine and the slower your internet speed, the longer the installation will take. So here it is, Windows 11 installed in an unsupported old machine. You can see that it is still the i7-3770 and the same storage we're using. And even though Microsoft did state that updates will no longer be guaranteed, it seems that Windows Update is still working fine. We're getting a security update for Microsoft Defender right now, ready to be downloaded. But you know, who knows? Maybe we can manually install updates instead in the future by the time they stop sending updates to unsupported devices. The Windows 11 is still activated as expected, and we have the latest OS build. But by any chance that you realize that this whole hype for Windows 11 is not worth the risk, you can go back to Windows 10 by going to Settings, System, look for Recovery, then press Go Back. Your machine will go back to Windows 10 like this whole thing we did never happened. So anyway, that's all I have for you today. If you have any questions, just comment down below and I'll try to answer it as soon as I can. This is the Remedy Guy. Thank you for watching.